What's this? CC? No. Oh, I guess I could visit Charles, right? Okay, I guess we'll visit Charles since we saved him from the Paris, the artist, the one that likes boobs. So I guess we could see him. Here, maybe? Gallery? Yeah, it's gotta be this.
Enjoy the show, if that's possible.
It's
a free show, so don't come asking for a refund.
I just don't like how much time you're spending with the man is all.
Just wait until you see his work. It's very progressive.
Well, I'm not so very sure how I feel about progression, paintings or otherwise.
Come on. You won't have seen the like of it before. I promise.
Maybe that's a good thing.
That's far too modern for my tastes.
Mr. Chardonnay, he's just a terror. It's making me blush.
I find the...
Oh yeah, his art is really baffling. Just women.
Look What's at he?
Not in mixed
Oh,
company.
He's over there. Really, I had to be
Look
close
at these
to him.
Idiots.
Excuse me, Mr. Chardonnay. Couldn't you have painted some drawers on her?
Madame, I paint her in her natural state, as she was and will be in paradise.
There's nothing natural about that.
Clothes are civilization, repression, death. To be naked is to be free, innocent, alive. Like Buddha said, you know, we are all just here to fuck.
Well, that explains the decadence of those Hottentots.
Hey, you got a picture of my wife here, in her... Delicate!
Henry, is that your behind? Why would you be showing it to that man?
That's my mama. As nude as the day she was born.
Stop looking at my husband's buttocks.
Stop looking at my mama.
Well, maybe she shouldn't expose herself like that.
This is disgusting.
The nerve on you!
That's it!
Come on, Mildred. This is no place for us.
Come here,
son of a bitch!
You filthy little man!
Hey, I'm coming after you, Frenchie!
Hey.
All right!
Oh, man. What?
Allez, allez, vite!
Yes, yes. Don't stop for me.
This way, come on. I think we are okay. The exhibition, what can you say? It was not boring!
It was not.
Art should test people, push them. I thought I was a fraud, a no talent brush washer. Now I'm not sure. We provoke emotions, no?
You keep provoking emotions like that, and all your canvases will have punch holes through.
I told you I was a hornass!
You did, and you are. Now maybe go be an asshole somewhere else for a while.
Here we are. I know a lady over here. She may let me stay for a while.
Good luck.
That picture I gave you, it will be worth something someday. I can feel it.
Perhaps. Right now, seems like the only thing it'll get me is kicking the balls.
Oh, you are funny, you know. I hope to see you again sometime.
Oh, dude, that's it? Why'd I follow him here? I'm sorry.
Look out, mister.
Whoa, look out!
Okay, a letter. Inspect.
My dear Arthur,
again?
I hope this letter finds you well. I wanted to thank you for your help with Jamie. He and Daddy are still arguing, but I understand that Jamie is thinking about going back to college. Whatever happens, I believe you saved his life and we are all truly grateful. Oh, Arthur, I have made such a mess of my life, time and again. Why can I not change and be the woman I want to be? Why couldn't you change and be a man and put down all those fantasies that shroud your judgment?
Arthur is a man.
Life is very confusing, and I see now that I am not very good at it. I'm afraid we've got ourselves into another mess. It's not my fault, but I need your help. I'm staying at the Hotel Grand in Saint Denis. Oh, Arthur, I know it is wrong to ask you, but I have nobody else, and for what we once had together, I beg of you, even though I am ashamed to do so. Yours, Mary.
Dude, what? Somewhere.
Arthur!
Where is
Arthur!
She? Oh.
Up here! You came!
Yeah. I came. So, what do you need?
Wait there! I'm coming straight down!
Who are they? What? Dude, why was she so happy? What happened? Arthur.
Arthur.
Hello, Mary.
You came.
Sure. Whenever you call for me, I'll come.
Oh, Arthur.
What's wrong?
Daddy.
Your father? I'm a bigger fool than I even thought.
I'm begging you, Arthur. I know Daddy was not kind to you, but surely you cannot hate a man for the sin of loving his daughter and wanting better for her than
me?
Than the choices you
what
make.
What choice did I have? Did I ever have?
Oh, I know. You had to live by your code. But your code is... Well, it's not right.
Has your way been right, Mary? With you and Jamie joining a bunch of crazies? And hypocritical daddy with his drinking and whoring and gambling? Huh? Is that what a pure life has gotten you? Begging me for help?
Oh, Arthur. Be kind to me. Please.
Sorry.
I am... I should have asked someone else, but...
But I'm the best guy you know at frightening decent people.
It wasn't that I didn't love you, Arthur. You know that.
No, no.
Oh, Arthur. We were so very young. Think how different life could have been.
Yeah, I think about it. A lot. It all seems so long ago and far away now.
Will you help me try to save Daddy?
Come along, Dan. Where are we going? What's the old lovable patriarch been up to now?
Oh, Arthur. You know sarcasm is beneath you. He's been gambling and drinking and other things.
Oh, the filthy rotter. Where can we find him?
He said he was going down to the Theodore Eckhart stables. Something about a horse. It's down by the water in the warehouse district near the train yard.
Come on, then.
Don't be a pompous ass, Arthur. It doesn't suit you.
Oh, should I leave that to Daddy?
Leave Daddy alone. He suffers enough.
Well, I suppose I can take some consolation in that.
No, Arthur. I should have ran away with you years ago.
Well, you wouldn't.
No, I didn't. But, well, I don't know.
Come on, man. She's confused.
So what do you think he's up to?
I'm not sure.
How did she know I was there?
He keeps saying it's a disgrace. A man of his standing has to ride around on some old nag.
Standing? He's usually falling down.
Arthur, he wasn't always this way, but it has got worse. He's drinking and gambling more than ever, pawning things off left and right, mixing with bad people. I'm just scared for him.
Don't worry too much. Whatever it is, we'll work it out.
This is the place.
Here, I'll clean you now.
Let me go in and see what kind of a state he's in.
Sure. I'll wait here. Good luck. Scream if you need any help.
Very funny.
Dude, is this a trap, actually?
You can't stand there.
What, in the street?
Yes, in the street.
Is it your street?
Just get out of here.
Why?
I said, just get out of here.
Listen, partner. I'm waiting on a lady. She's a fine lady. She's just gone inside. If I wasn't waiting on this lady, you'd be dead already. But if you continue to irritate me, I'll kill you. And make my apologies to the lady. It's your call.
Oh, I didn't mean nothing.
Never been so demeaned in my life.
Apology accepted. Oh, wait, daughter. Right there.
I have half a mind to kill you myself.
Daddy.
No.
Oh, Daddy, please, come home. You're tired, Daddy, tired and
I have
unwell.
No such thing. You get away from me. You head home. I insist upon it. Leave me be. Damn nuisance.
Excuse me, partner. Still as charming as ever, I see.
Oh, Arthur. He's up to no good. We better follow him.
Okay.
Ay, ay, ay.
What's he doing? What do you think he's doing?
Well, he's either waiting for a woman of dubious morals, or he's trying to sell something.
So, Ashton, you got the money?
Seems he's selling something.
Have you got the brooch, Mr. Gillis?
Yes. Here.
Here's the money.
That is beautiful.
It's a family heirloom.
That was mother's brooch.
Not any longer, Mr. Gillis. Enjoy the money. And should you need any more, I can offer you a loan at a very reasonable rate of interest.
No, thank you. I've heard what happens to folks who take loans from you.
It's not his to sell.
No, it's just a brooch. At least he didn't get himself killed.
You don't understand. Mother left it to me. You sold my mother's brooch? How could you?
You!
That's theft!
Oh, speaking of thieves, I see you found your outlaw again.
Hello, sir. Have you been well?
Daddy, how could you?
Mary, wait here. I'll go get the brooch.
Don't hurt anyone, Arthur.
He'll probably kill someone. Oh, but you like that, don't you, Mary? Hello!
Leave me alone. It's just a brooch.
I want that brooch. It wasn't Gillis's to sell.
I bought it fair and square.
How much do you want for it?
I guess I could give it to you for $100.
$100? What do you take me for?
Okay. I'm a reasonable man. Let's say 50.
Here,
take the damn thing.
Crazy son of a bitch. You don't know who you're messing with. Somebody's gonna pay for this.
Come on, pal. Here.
with the lasso out. I wanted to catch him and tie him up somewhere so that he doesn't send trouble our way, but it seems like no.
Where's your father?
I don't know.
You want me to go find him again?
Not really.
Now let's take a walk. I'll take you to the trolley.
Thank you.
Got you your brooch back.
I won't ask.
Probably best not.
Nothing happened, man. I didn't kill. He didn't kill.
Hey. What are you doing now? Right this moment?
Why'd you ask?
Well, I was wondering if you wanted to do something. Head to the theater, perhaps.
Sure.
Theater? Me? Sure, why not?
It'll be fun, Arthur. Let's go to the Relure. They have the strangest acts.
Strangeness I can handle. Well, it's the normal business of life I can't seem to get a grip on.
You and me both, Arthur. Oh, I've missed you.
Don't start.
You're an idiot. But you'll always be my friend.
Well, of course I'm your friend, but you ain't always fair with me.
If I was fair with you and a good person, I'd have had you hanged a long time ago.
Well, that's true.
So, shut up and act like a gentleman, or at least try to for once in your brainless life.
You're not a very nice woman, Mrs. Lynn.
Well, look at the company I keep.
I know, it's quite dreadful, isn't it?
Damn.
It's sort of beautiful, in a gaudy and tasteless way.
It's the only way I know.
Thank you.
Well, no, I didn't mean it like that.
I'm sure. You silly man. Come on, let's go find our seats.
Okay, what's gonna be this nonsense? I wasn't expecting we'd actually see a show here.
Welcome! And thank you for that thunderous applause. I am Aldridge T. Abington, the greatest assembler of entertainment since Nero himself. Do not doubt. As a child, when I walked the horse manure-covered streets of Saint-Denis, I never dreamed of the stir I would create
so,
in this locality
just
as
starting
a proprietor
or not.
Are you in
of
a
the
rush,
greatest
Arthur?
Show ever assembled. Prepare for the grandest excitement of your curiosity. Fire, snakes, and magic. I encourage any of you to dabble in all three if you have a settled aversion to manual labor as I do. For entertainment is a gift that will see you through the winter better than any packed larder or root cellar full of canned goods. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a truly stunning musical performance to the stage, Miss Robin Koninsky!
They come from Rogue Strawberry and Valentine, singing a song. Across Bayou Swamp and over the sea,
we're heading
down to Saint-Denis. If your wagon is broken to the blacksmith shop, don't worry yourself with planting a crop. The girls are wearing a brand new gown. We're heading to the Saint-Denis town. Yes, I'd rather live in Saint-Denis. So draw your money, come see your honey in old Saint-Denis.
That was not so bad.
I see you love her dulcet tones, right? Yes, she is pure spectacle, and I assure you she can charm any beast at all, from cockroach to killer whale. Your mother most likely told you not to play with fire or to spend time in the company of strange women. You are about to do both. Miss Antoinette Sanserino. Yeah!
Woo! Bring her out!
Stop it. Look at that. This lady is exotic as all get out.
See how this could go horribly wrong.
I hope she stays away from the curtain.
Yeah!
A lot of respect for belly dancers.
Enchanting! Mesmerizing! She is truly one to bring home to mother. It is said that there is a place in France where the naked ladies dance. I have been there. Prepare for the body brassieres of the Petit Flaneur in Gay Paris!
Where's Charles? There's a guy yelling that. Okay, that was entertaining. I wish I could do that.
All right. Well, shall we?
Yes. That was fun, Arthur.
It was.
All right. You better take me to the trolley now, Mr. Morgan.
Of course.
Quite ridiculous, but somehow very amusing.
Sure.
My life wasn't supposed to... Oh. Is it too late for us, Arthur?
I can't lie to you. I'm a wanted man, Mary. If anyone close to me, well, they're wanted to, and I can't have you wrapped up in there. But it's coming to an end. This time it really is.
Run away with me, Arthur. Run away right now and don't look back.
I want to. More than anything, I want to. But I've got some people I need to take care of. Once they're free, then I'm free. Then I can disappear.
But Arthur...
If we're gonna run away anywhere, we'd need money. Soon, I'll have some.
I know you won't run away. But it's a pretty dream.
Very pretty. But I will. Once I get some money. I had some. But then some fool got it trapped into a town that I can't go back to. That's another story.
I'll write you.
Yeah.
Hey, you know what? Why don't I race you back?
Okay, you're on.
That's the spirit.